Hi, I'm Sue from the city of Vaughan. I'd like to share some exercises with you that you can do at home. The exercises I'm going to demonstrate are specifically for the time program. As many of you know, the time program is designed for people who have balance and mobility restrictions due to stroke, MS, Parkinson's, acquired brain injury, or other neurological conditions. The benefits for the participants in doing the time program is that they can challenge and improve their range of motion. They can improve their balance and strength, especially in the core and the legs. They can decrease the risk of falls, and they can increase their confidence in completing daily mobility tasks. If you're going to participate today, please keep your own safety in mind. If you're not familiar with these exercises, take your time and don't feel you have to keep up with me. Go at your own speed. Also, make sure there's somebody in your house should you require assistance. And if anything causes you discomfort, stop and rest. Now let's make sure you have a sturdy chair, preferably one with armrests, though as you notice, I don't have armrests on my chair. Have some water ready in case you need it, and make sure that the floor around your chair is free of obstacles. Now let's sit at the front of the chair, sit up nice and tall with our back away from the back of the chair so we can start our warm up. We start with four nice deep breaths, using your arms to help lift the rib cage as you inhale. And one more deep breath in. And exhale. Now we're going to place your hands on your thighs. Just drop your chin down to your chest and gently roll your head to one side, bringing your ear to the shoulder, and then rolling your chin across the chest, taking the other ear to the other shoulder. And do this three more times. Keep it nice and slowly. Try not to hold your breath at any point during this video. And just enjoy the movement. And after you've done four times, lift your head up. We're now going to turn our head to the left, looking over that left shoulder and coming back to the center. One more time, just looking with the head. Good. This time we're going to look with the head, and then we're going to turn our body using the armrest on the side of your chair, or if you're like me and don't have armrests, then use the outside of that left thigh to help push yourself around a little bit. Always working within the level that feels comfortable for you. Let's do three more times. Turn the head, turn the body, using the armrest or the leg to help you go maybe that little bit further as you rotate around the spine. Two more times. And one last time, maybe looking a little bit further this time than you did the last time. Let's go to the right side now. Turn your head only, looking towards the right and coming back to center. Turning your head to the right and back to center. Let's turn the entire body again. You can use the armrest or the outside of that right thigh to help you go a little bit further around before coming back to center. Let's do three more. Try to look a little bit further each time you go. You're still sitting up nice and straight and tall. Always rotating, only to where it feels right for you. One last time. And back to the center. We're going to do some lateral movements now, bending side to side. We're going to put the left hand up on the left shoulder. The right hand reaches down to the floor. And we lean sideways, trying to reach our right fingers down to the floor. We're going to feel the stretch in the side, and we're going to try to push that left elbow up to touch the ceiling or to reach towards the ceiling and then come back down. Reaching that right hand to the floor, the left hand this time can reach up to the ceiling or feel free to keep the hand on the shoulder. And coming back up. Reaching down and up. And just one more time. Good. Let's take it to the other side. Bring that right hand up to the right shoulder. The left hand reaches down to the floor, stretching through the side. That right elbow reaching up towards the ceiling and then coming up. This segment is designed to be done after the warm-up and is for strengthening the legs and the core. And I think you'll find you'll get a bit of a cardiovascular challenge as well. And because your safety is important, if you're participating in this, please make sure you have somebody at home should you require any assistance. Also, make sure you work at your own pace, and if something causes you discomfort, then stop and rest. You may want to have some water with you as well in case you get thirsty. Are you ready to get started? Let's move to the front of the chair and have our feet about hip width apart. And we can start with a nice march, holding our stomach muscles nice and tight. We're not using the back of the chair. And we start with an easy march. If you want to do this standing up, just make sure you have something close by for your balance. Otherwise, you can get a bit more of a challenge by going faster or lifting your knees up a little bit higher, but work, as I said, at the level that feels right for you. We're going to go into a heel tap now. So all we do is take a heel forward and tap the floor and pull it back. One leg at a time. We can add some bicep curls to keep the upper body involved. And as you're bringing your heels back, if your chair allows you, try to bring your foot underneath the chair so that you can work the hamstring muscle or the muscle at the back of your thigh a little bit more. Very good. From here, we're going to increase the intensity a little bit more. If you want, you can keep holding this position, or you can change it to a kick, kicking the leg out. And if you want, you can add an opposite arm reach to the foot, reaching it up. Try to straighten that leg, reach, keeping your body nice and straight. Trying to remember, you don't want to hold your breath. Just a nice, steady breathing. Good. And then bringing your legs and arms down, we're going into something like a jumping jack, taking the leg out to the side. And again, we can add some arms if we like. Do as much or as little as feels right for you and work on increasing a little bit more each time you try it. And let's just go back to a march. You can repeat that segment again if you like, or you can join me right now as we go into the strengthening segment of it, with starting off with our sit to stand exercises. For these, we want our feet about hip width apart. sitting again at the edge of the chair, we're going to reach forward, or you can use your armrests to help push you up if you don't quite have enough strength in your legs today. Otherwise, you can reach forward, bending at the hips, keeping the back straight, pushing through your legs and standing up, and then pushing your hips back to sit back down on the chair. Coming up and back. Good. To challenge yourself a little bit more, maybe you want to just hover above the chair before coming up. I'm doing it 8 times, but feel free to do as many as feels comfortable for you. Remember, stop and take a rest if you need to. We've got one more. Good. And sitting down. Very nice. We're going to move to the back of the chair now to do some other exercises. So think about that position to get up. Lean forward. Push yourself right up. And let's come around to the back of our chair. We're going to start off with side leg raises. I'm going to move my chair just a little bit so you can see. Holding on with one hand or with both hands right behind your chair, we take one leg out to the side and slowly bring it down. Again, we're going to try for 8 times on each leg. And if you want, you can always add the opposite arm for a little bit more of a challenge. There's 8 on that side. Let's go to the other side. And with my space, it's easier just for me to move my chair, taking it out to the side, up. Nice steady pace, not holding your breath, keeping your body up nice and straight. And again, if we want to add for these last 4, that hand in opposition, we can do that. Very good. And if you like, just circle those shoulders around. Get rid of any tension that you might be feeling. And let's end off with 3 nice deep breaths, using those arms to lift the rib cage. Inhale deeply and exhale. Thank you for joining me. Be safe and have yourself a good day. Bye for now.